terrible dream for the Kremlin in reality. Such a serious drop in oil prices came as a complete surprise to the Kremlin. The oil war with Saudi Arabia got out of control, during which Putin's Russia incurs tremendous losses. In fact, the revenge of the Saudis led to a technical oil embargo against Putin's Russia. It also turned out that the Saudis control the main triggers of the Russian economy, indirectly control the price of Russian oil, devalue it, and controls the value of the ruble against the dollar, actually holding us by the throat. And then there's the embargo. The fact is that for the second week in a row, oil traders cannot sell a barrel of Russian Urals oil to Europe through ports. The lack of buyers is forcing traders to leave Russian oil in tankers, turning them into floating storage facilities, where Russian oil barrels will wait for better times. And whether they come, and when, well, no one knows. The Russian economy, which receives two-thirds of its foreign exchange earnings from hydrocarbon exports, which caused the Saudis to collapse in the oil market, seems to have a heart attack as a result of a technical oil embargo in revenge. And this is all happening despite the declared discounts on Russian oil at $3-4 of the price. It's just that the Russian pumped slurry called oil is becoming less attractive, while Saudi price offers a discount of $6 or more from the main one, a beckoning with the temptation to buy more and more. Moreover, this is not the peak of extraction and export announced by Riyadh. The fact is that Saudi Arabia promised for months to fill the market with cheap oil, and apparently she will do so. For revenge, you see, is a dish that needs to be served cold. But the Saudis still have something to avenge the Kremlin. Meanwhile, Russian Urals oil peaked below $20 a barrel. Also, the rapid collapse of the ruble is taking place against the backdrop of falling oil prices, where the ruble reached 82 rubles for $1, and the Kubushka, which is called to save and temporarily keep Russia afloat, under the name of the National Welfare Fund, is already bursting at the seams. P.S. Lukoil vice president said what they couldn't imagine in a nightmare, and called for $15 to prepare for oil. $15 a barrel, Carl. And here also the Japanese bank Mizuho predicts that the price of oil may reach a negative value. The explanation gives a completely logical and understandable one. They say that with the current gap in falling demand and the sharply increased supply of oil storage, they are filling up at a very rapid pace. In about a month and a half, all available oil storage capacities will be fully utilized. Next comes the time of tankers, which are a reserve of last hope, the rental rates of which have already quadrupled. After they are finished, the producers will face the question, stop production or pay premiums to buyers so that they take their oil, which, in general, will lead to a collapse of the already low oil price and the achievement of its negative value, even in the State Duma, realizing the tragedy of the current moment in Putin's Russia. They called on the Russians to escape from the crisis, all at the expense of their gardens. History repeats itself. Putin and his comrades will bury the Russian Federation, as the Soviet elite buried the Soviet Union with their own hands. Only this will happen much faster. Let me remind you that this whole story began only because of the unreasonable and not timely decision of Putin's Russia to refuse to reduce production in response to coronavirus and the statements of senior officials of the Russian Federation that Saudi Arabia became, from their words, supposedly a weak link in the oil market, which seems to be in earnest angered the royal family of Saudi Arabia. All this was said with all this, that Saudi Arabia pulled the deal to limit oil production almost single-handedly, exceeding its obligations and voluntarily reducing production over Putin's Russia, as usual. Deceive OPEC partners, the Saudis themselves said in response to the Russian Federation. They also said that Putin's Russia was given many chances, but now the decision has been made to show integrity and to punish her for insulting in many years of deception. Following the Saudis, Iran, Kuwait, the United Arab Emirates, as well as Russia's friendly Nigeria, also declared the oil war of the Russian Federation. And Saudi Arabia curtailed plans to invest in the Russian fuel and energy complex. The deal to sell the Saudis a stake in Novomet, the Russian oilfield services company, which had been in preparation for more than 2 years and was designed to hold the Kremlin and Riyadh oil union in cash, fell apart along with the OPEC agreement. And along with it, Putin's Russia lost another tricky way to circumvent US sanctions and still get new oil production technologies. Just after Europe and China began to abandon Russian oil after Europe. The trouble in the European oil markets, where Saudi oil poured at a discount of as much as $10 to Brent, came to the Russian oil industry not one. The largest state-owned petrochemical company in China, under the name Sinochem, has decided to abandon purchases from Rosneft due to US sanctions. Sinochem planned to buy oil in the Russian Federation as before. However, now in the tender materials it has been specified as a separate clause that Rosneft or its subsidiaries cannot be a supplier. Since March, two trading subsidiaries of the largest oil company of the Russian Federation, Rosneft Trading and TNK Trading, are on the US sanctions list. At the same time, Chinese Sinochem is afraid to work with Rosneft itself, knowing that US sanctions can be drastically tightened and imposed on Rosneft itself. All this means that the loss of Chinese customers will be another new unpleasant blow for the Russian oil industry. And we will go further, while everyone is talking about problems with oil. Or rather, its low price. They forget to mention another scrap of the Russian economy called Gazprom, which earlier, after constantly informing about victories and new gas supplies to non-CIS countries, stopped this practice in January and became silent. Now sits quietly, and all because, as they say, our oil and gas are everything. And the prices for them are extremely low, and we suffer huge losses. Even Kudrin said that because of all this, the budget of the Russian Federation will lose 3 trillion rubles. Therefore, the Russian government has already committed the crime of spending the last crumbs from the National Welfare Fund, for the money of which the whole queue has already been lined up, because there will not be enough for everyone. Meanwhile, it became known that in May 2020, hearings will begin on the suit of Ukrainian Naftogaz already to the Russian Federation and Gazprom as much as a whopping $8 billion. And that's all, only for the occupation of Crimea. Naftogaz and 6 other Ukrainian companies are demanding from Putin's Russia compensation for losses caused by the illegal expropriation of Crimean assets. The amount of losses plus interest is estimated at approximately $8 billion. It is also worth mentioning that it became known that all Gazprom reserves, ostensibly selling foreign currency earnings, were thrown to support the falling ruble, stupidly burning, but in fact, which Gazprom itself lent in December through the placement of Eurobonds. Thus, Russia became even closer to default.